As I cleared the wood, or some of the saplings, and in this case it was becoming a tree, it was a dogwood, I saved the stumps, or the trunks, even though they weren't very big, just not knowing. At worst it could be firewood, but at best maybe I'd think of something to do with it. So I started getting into cutting these little bandsaw boxes, or I was wanting to get into it. And I got to looking at this and I thought, well, you know, I can block this off and make me a square. And then I'm going, wait a minute, why do I need to block that off? Just cut it. And so I began to realize, I didn't understand that for my first bandsaw box, this was not the one I wanted to do. There was a lot more complexity to it than it looked like. Whereas if you're working with squared, flat blanks, it makes all your walls are a lot straighter. But anyway, so wound up with a little imperfection and a little funkiness, but then again, that makes it very unique. It makes it what it is. We wanted to preserve the bark as best we could. But anyway, this is a little dogwood bandsaw box, and this is how I did it. Now you'll want to follow your cut into here, follow all the way around here, follow up to here, come around, and then back your blade out. Now the trick is, when you're freehanding this, you got to hold it where it's level. You can't let it drift sideways like so. All right, that's the tricky part. Now, you'll take this part, you'll have to glue this section right here back together. Now, you'll take these, since we want to keep the bark intact, we want to keep the bark intact here, you have to carefully do this. I just do it by eye. A good little tip I've run across on YouTube, somebody was taking their little pieces like this and putting a backer on it. Good idea. ready for glue up. Number two, ready for glue. Okay, so now, like I said, we've got to glue this. This is the piece this came from. Once that's glued, now we've got to glue up a drawer. Simple enough. Orient your pieces in the correct direction. And then, a little glue. Keep a damp rag close by. Now here comes the fun part. This glue tends to want to move around a bit on you. So what you got to do is you just got to keep adjusting it until it starts to set a little bit. Both sides, but if you work at it, you can get it to line up pretty much where your cut was made. The cut becomes less and less visible the better you line it up. Starting to tacky up a little bit. I like to make sure there's a glue seal around every part of the edge. Then once I get it very close, I like to get the excess glue off of the wood. Slightly damp cloth makes it a whole lot easier when it comes sanding time. Now you want to get your final placement. I can sort of feel with my fingers when I'm in line if I can touch both sides. Now this is kind of delicate right here because it will still move on you. So you got to be careful as you apply pressure, sort of a little bit both sides a little at a time. There you go. Let that sit. Let that cook for a while. Okay, now comes time to glue up our little cut where, unlike a jigsaw, which you can drill a hole and enter the saw blade, you can't do that with a bandsaw. So you have to come up in here. We've got to glue that back. So here we go. I try to go in and the excess squeeze out I put back into saw cuts on the inside, because they need to be filled as well. Alright, I think that matches up pretty good. I try to make sure the cut underneath is level and the cut back here is level, because this you can't really tell. Show you the cut from the other side. I don't know if this makes it any clearer or not, but there it was, our cut line. It's hidden pretty well. All right, let's let that dry. Here's the final product on our stump bandsaw box. Notice the detail. This is made out of dogwood. A lot of spalting and stuff going on in there. Got a neat little, I don't know if you can see this from there, but used a twig for the front part. But anyway, that turned out. Thanks for watching.